Hi, Chuck Huber here for the Stata YouTube channel. I'd like to continue our series on the treatment effects features in Stata. This time we'll be talking about the regression adjustment estimator. Let's begin by opening some example data. Let's click File at the top left and go down to Example Datasets. And then we're going to click Stata 13 Manual Datasets. We're going to have to scroll down a bit and select Treatment Effects Reference Manual. And then under Treatment Effects RA, we can select cataneo2.dta by clicking Use. And that will open the data set from across the web. This is the same data set that we've been using for our other examples. And just to review, we're interested in the effect of mother's smoking status during pregnancy on the birth weight of her newborn infant. We can find the treatment effects estimators under Statistics, Treatment Effects, and we're going to select Regression Adjustment. In the T Effects dialog box, the first tab we see on the left is the Model tab. If we'd like to change the estimator for some reason, we can change the estimator, but in this case, we're just going to leave it selected, leave Regression Adjustment selected. We can now make our selections for our outcome model. The outcome dependent variable is going to be birth weight, and the outcome independent variables are going to be M-married, which is an indicator for variable for whether or not the mother was married, M-age, which is the mother's age, prenatal 1, which is an indicator for whether the mother had a prenatal visit during the first trimester, and then we have F-baby, which is an indicator for whether this is the mother's first baby or not. So this is the outcome model. As I've mentioned in other videos, there's no reason that our outcome model must be linear. If we had a binary outcome, we could use a Loget, Probit, or heteroscedastic Probit outcome model. And if we had count data, we could use a Poisson outcome model. The treatment model for the regression adjustment estimator is simply the treatment variable, which in this case is MB smoke, which is an indicator for whether or not the mother smoked during pregnancy. And then we have some other options we can consider in the other tabs. The by if n tab, of course, allows us to run our analysis on a subsample of the data, subset of the data. The weights tab allows us to incorporate frequency weights or importance weights if we need them. The SE robust tab allows us to select the method for calculating our standard errors. The default is robust, but we could do bootstrap or jackknife standard errors. And then the reporting maximization and advanced tabs contain other options if we'd like to select them. The stat tab is unique to the treatment effects estimators. It allows us to select whether we'd like to estimate potential outcome means or estimate average treatment effects in the population, or we could also estimate the average treatment effect among the treated only or on the treated only. So let's begin by estimating potential outcome means. I'm going to click submit to run the command, and then I'm going to move this dialog box off to the side. Let's take a quick look at the command. The command is TEffectsRA, and then we have two sets of parentheses here. The first set of parentheses contains the outcome model. In this case, the outcome dependent variable is birth weight, and then we have our covariates included. Then the second set of parentheses contain the outcome model, which in this case is only the outcome variable MB smoke, or I'm sorry, the treatment model, and it only contains the treatment variable MB smoke. Then the option comma PO means tells Stata that we'd like to estimate the potential outcome means in each of the two groups. At the top of the output, we see some review of which estimator we're using and what kind of outcome model and so forth. We see the number of observations included in our model. And then our coefficient table shows us that the average birth weight of the infants of mothers who smoked was approximately 3,164 grams. And the birth weight for infants of mothers who chose not to smoke is approximately 3,403 grams. Now, if we wanted to know the effect of smoking on birth weight, infant birth weight, we could simply subtract the two coefficients. But we could come back to our dialog box and select Estimate Average Treatment in the Population, and then click Submit again. And Stata will rerun the command, this time with no options. And we notice that there is now a section at the top of the output labeled ATE for Average Treatment Effect. And here we can see that the coefficient is minus 239, which indicates that the infants of mothers who smoked were approximately 240 grams lighter on average than infants of mothers who did not smoke. And by using the ATE option, we also get standard errors and confidence intervals for that estimate. Okay, so if we wanted to, we could also estimate the average treatment effect on the treated only, so we could check that option and click submit again. And now Stata will rerun the model with the option comma ATET at the end, and we can see the output looks very similar to the ATE output. Okay, so that's the basics of how we can run the regression adjustment estimator in Stata. I hope this was helpful. Thanks for stopping by.